good, relevant time of day to you all. Welcome to Like the Seamus, and I'm Seamus. You're watching Handle Up Games. You can follow us at Handle Up on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Handle Up Games right here on Twitch. Eon's End, Bottom of the Ninth, One Deck Dungeons, Centrals of the Multiverse, and Spirit Island are currently available for iOS, Android, and PC, Mac, and Linux via Steam. And as always, good old fashioned cardboard and ink. You can get these games and more info at handlearbor.com. Handle Up believes in civil rights for everyone and in being as inclusive as possible, so any comments or activity actively working against that goal is not welcome and will not be tolerated. Hello, hello, hello! Yes, we have new mods! Ah, yes, I've got to get back to that, and you have to start art, Zach! Or at least talk to me about starting the art for it. So yes, we have two new mods this week. We had the Riverport mod by Barkoglyph, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 heroes and a lab. And it's not showing up here. We also have the Darkmine mod, so let me see if that actually worked. No, they were an all new set in the villains. Oh no, Darkmine didn't load. Give me 1 second to check my mods folder. Ah, that's why it didn't work. Yes. Okay. Right, I will have to speak to him about that. Right. Give me one moment. I'm going to reload Sentinels and hopefully that will bring back the Darkmine mod. Ah, yes, we do have the Darkmine mod. Darkmine is just a single villain version of the words. Words are failing me. One of the Scions of Oblivion. We've got a bunch of heroes. Nightlord's Citadel is there, but we're going to show off once again labs and go to the heroes and find some of the Riverport. Oh, Drifter's available! Okay, I guess I know what I'm doing for my second turn. My second game, but for the moment, we'll take a look. Okay, so Trail Waver starts with Prepared Ambush, Trail of Ashes, Uncharted Grounds, and Vantage Point. Weaver starts with Inertia Patch, Inspiration Strikes, Sight Patch, and Quick Weaving, Spellforge, Articulate the Lethological, Controlled. Oh wait, this is the wrong hero. That is true. A feeling. And Ray, this is not from Riverport. That's my mistake. And Fenris starts with By the Moonlight, Geek and Sunder, Great Cleave, and Meditate. Okay, Dark Mind. Starts at the start of the game, Dark Mind enters play Deadly Spectre side up. Possession is put into play next to the hero with the highest HP. That hero is possessed. When possession is removed from play, the hero who was possessed draws 4 cards. The filling deck is shuffled. Gameplay. Possession cannot be affected by non-villain cards. When possession is destroyed, remove it from play and flip Dark Mind's character cards. At the start of the villain turn, Dark Mind deals the possessed hero 3 reducible psychic damage. At the end of the villain turn, the possessed hero deals each hero target other than themselves 2 melee damage. If the possessed hero is ever incapacitated, remove possession from the game. If there are ever 4 villain ongoing cards in play or 4 projection cards in play, remove possession from the game. Okay. So, possession. Giant Praying Mantis. At the end of the turn, this. Okay. Bunch of two melees. In the winter, this card deals the 2 possessed hero, non-possessed hero targets with the highest HP. And okay. So everybody's taking damage every round. So I'm just quickly reading these cards. Start with that. Okay, let's let you draw 2 extra cards. Okay, Eva. Right, so I'm going into play. Let's reduce your damage by 1. And then what do you want to do? Okay, we have prefix, suffix, essence. Right, we have one shot, which is... Okay. So you can now add two suffixes to this. Okay, so we want more prefixes. Right, so we want essence. Suffix. Okay, I was possibly reading that wrong. Oh, okay, this is a werewolf. Okay, I'm really not sure what to do here, because I don't want to kill anything. Oh, we'll go with draw two cards. And then this is draw a card. And then draw a card. More cards. I'm not sure why I just transformed. Oh right, sorry, it's random card from the top of my deck. So, do I want to do one target, two melee damage? No. What does Frenzy do? Skip. Well, hey, at least we can beat up the environment. useless to. Just going to play that. Let's get the spell forge cards. Okay, Weaver. I don't want to particularly do any of that, so we'll just play a patch. Who wants cards? Actually, Weaver wants cards. Okay, two essences. Okay. I do not want to stay as wolf. Yes, yes, there is. Well, again, what's my switch pick at the moment? There appears to be lots of dragons in this environment. destroy another card. For the long going is play off projection cards and play. Okay. Okay, I'll do that. Yes. That's nice. Although I could actually kill him and let build up ongoing cards, but okay, I do not have any heals . Do we have anything that will kill an environment card? Oh, right. played it with one. Okay. Didn't allow me to search for the Pale Moon Pendant to put into play. I don't want to play any of those. Draw a card. Okay, we're up to 3 ongoing cards. Just got two of the numbers. Okay, and that was Spellforge. Okay. To be honest, it's not making much of a difference at the moment. Suppose we can kill him, 2 damage. I'm just going to skip that. Okay. That's for later. Okay. So two cards. Okay, we'll discard another one of those. And keep that for later. Discard that. Okay. Right, yes. So you've only got your In part of your turn, do we have an essence to play? We do. That's each target. So controlled and for the suffix. Okay, Fenrir. Okay. So with all this bonus ongoing plays, can you please play an ongoing? Okay, 26 HP. Some play card, Trailblazer. Okay. I think we're actually going to be faster killing the boss. So we don't want to transform, then play Frenzy. Come on, where's your damage? There we go. Oh, right. I'm sure you've put up to 3 patches now. So, play that. Oh, I'm fine here. Copy that. Off in here. I'll play that. Off in here. Can you play a card? Trailblazer. Nope. To play. Play a card. Yes. Yes. Okay, the appearance of Softlocked. Fenrir cannot deal damage for some reason. Okay. Well, that just ruins his entire 10. Because I just destroyed the three cards that would allow him to deal damage. So that would allow him to heal. And he can't do anything. Okay. Just check something. Can I deal damage? Cannot deal damage and have to skip phases. This is over because he's got no way to kill the thing that's stopping him dealing damage. I'm just going to end this and go for a new game. Okay. Yes, I did see Outlander. Heroes. We have a bunch of new heroes in here as well. So, Inquirer, Cassie, Weaver, Trailblazer, Dragon Table we didn't look at, Archive we didn't look at. And because some people have done some amazing work, there's a Drift. And Scarlet X. Environments. I saw there was a Nightlord here. Nightlord Citadel. Bunch more new stuff. Okay. So Archite starts with deploy spares, pair of hastened actions and recycled ideas. Drift starts with attenuation field. Destroys Adagio. Throwing shard and transition shock. Dragon Tamer starts with bite. Learning experience. Tortuga and We Fight as One. An Artificer starts with delayed activation, mana burn, quest complete, and Shyphon. What is this archive called? Well, it gets free and put 5 tokens into the mana pool. At the start of your turn, add a token to the mana pool. Okay, Artificer starts with the mana pool. Outlander. Outlander, Fragmented Rift Warrior. At the start of the game, put Outlander's villain card into play, Fragmented Rift Warrior side up. Search the villain deck for all trace cards and put them beneath this card. Put one random trace card from beneath this one into play. Shuffle the villain deck. Cards beneath this one are not considered in play. Trace cards are indestructible. An Outlander would be destroyed instead of flip his villain, the character cards. So here's 5 trace cards, which you can't see at the moment, which he adds one each time you kill him, and once they're all there, so. First time Outlander deals damage turn, he deals. Ooh, let's stop the blue. When one records shift left or right, move the shift token one space in that direction if possible. Only if it moves does it count as left or right. till the token is on this. While the token is on something space activated. Sorry, past space activates its past effect. While the token is on its future space activates its future effect. Let's. So the first time Outland deals damage each turn, he deals to a target with the highest HP 2 projectile damage. At the end of one turn, Outland deals 2 hit targets with the lowest HP 1 projectile damage each. The anchored fragment. Stronger than 10 of Outlanders, but was not dealt at least 8 damage in the last round. Destroy 4 hero ongoing Outland equipment cards. Okay, so. The top card of the window, you can play a plan or an active plan. Okay. So an act is play a card. That's the same reason why I wouldn't want to second one of these and play. Oh! Are they supposed to be limited? Nope. Okay, let's look for a piece of equipment. Okay, I don't know why that went to the drift variance. Okay. Fine, let's find out what nanobots are and what they do. Spare nanobots. Let's take a clear cut. Yeah, because she only breaks her own stuff. Guys breaks everything. Let's take all 7. Okay, why wasn't the anchor fragment destroyed? Between. I mean, more than 8 damage was done to it. Use the power. You're in the past, so let's draw a card. Nope, 1 second. Drift and Outlander are both Cauldron, the other three are. These three characters are the in the future that we can destroy an ongoing card. Yep, I have trouble doing it as well. So what do we get Dragonborn? So the first time he's dealt damage, each turn he deals source the damage to fire damage. Yes, yes they are. I don't have anything I can do there. I'm also going to use an extra power. We're in the path, so let's draw a card. In the past. I believe you had some ongoing destruction of it. Nope. Okay. Anchored Franklin wasn't destroyed. However, it's not forcing me to destroy ongoing equipment cards. Do I have any plans on my trash? I do. There's no point doing that because there's ancient damage. That should be worth it. Yes, because that flips him. Okay. More flips, which we're not likely to get through, to be honest. Okay. Oh no, yes, I was talking about Outlander glitches. I think this is just about over with. Yep, that's it done. Okay. Oh, when he took out the last starlight, just, you know, because he could. Okay. Well, okay, apparently he's going to keep going and destroy himself. Okay. Wait, main menu. Probably have time for a reasonably fast game. What would people like to see? Right, okay. No one? Right, I have never fought Mythos. So where is Mythos? But if we're gonna fight Mythos, we might as well bring Crow. Cause you know, Necro. Lady of the Word. Starlight. And Dark Havoc. In the environment. Yes, I know. Let's take another look at the Once Again Labs and fight. Ooh, spooky. Lady of the Woods starts with Calm Before the Storm, Fall, Sunkissed Mantle, and Winter. Dark Havoc starts with Cauterize, Dark Slash, Improvised Mine, and Painkillers. Starlight starts with a pair of constellations. That's rare for me. Usually I have to go digging for them. Celestial Order and Mirth Shift. Necro starts with Chaotic Summons, Corpse Explosion, and pair of Grand Summons. And Mythos. Ooh. Strategy game put Mythos' villain character card into play in substantial room side up. Search the villain deck for dangerous investigations and put it into play. Shuffle the villain deck. Gameplay. Mythos and dangerous investigations are indestructible. Activate any danger, madness, clue effects that match the icon at the top of the villain deck. Danger Mythos is immune to damage. At the end of the villain turn, the players may play up to 5 cards from the top of the villain deck. Then there are 4 tokens on Dangerous Investigation, Flip Mythos' villain character cards. Okay. So, clue. At the end of the villain turn, the players may play the top part of the villain deck to add a token to this card. At the end of the villain turn, Mythos deals the XO target highest number, highest HP, 3 infernal damage rates, 4 minus the number of villain cards the players choose to play this turn. Okay. Danger increased damage dealt by environment cards, to your targets by 1, and at the end of the villain turn, this card deals each hero target psychic damage, and we're currently at a clue. So if I was to play 4 cards, well, 3 cards, I'd be back to Clue and he would do less, so yes. Cold for winter. Okay. And we'll move it next to Necro. Oh, and we're off to the races. Okay. So. I put three on last turn, so yes. So that'll be four tokens on him. So he should flip next turn. Frosty, can you? Excellent. Okay. Yes, I am. Oh no, corpse explosion. Oh wait, he slipped. So, yes, it does. So, am I actually adding tokens to him? Because it doesn't appear to. Almost there. Okay. No. Right, okay. Oh no, my abomination was destroyed. Is there supposed to be an indicator as to how many tokens he has? Because I have definitely played more than four cards from this. And they are not showing up. Grand, thank you. One land. Okay. And bottom of the deck, zombie in the trash. I want the Mirror Shield to play. I do have Constellation of Trash, I do. And I will put it next to Crow. Okay. Put Hellfire into play. Got a guy we can kill. So, yes. Okay, clue. At the end. Right. So there has to be a clue in play. Sorry, there has to be a clue at the top of the deck in order for it to put a token there. Ah, that's what I was missing. So we need to be putting the clues into play, not anything else. Right, okay. So, yes. No, that's enough. By you. Necro gains 2 HP. Okay. So let's get the warp in, actually. Let's do this. Spend. So Starlight then gets warp halo into play. And actually, okay. So we'll get Necro to play his talisman against Trash, so lowest is Lady the Word, the lowest, and that's the second lowest, which is actually Necro. Actually correct. So danger, danger, madness, danger. I won't play, yes. Thank you. Okay. Okay then. Only three targets, so one is going to have to be toxic. Which lady the word. No. Fire will go here. Yes. Lightning will go there. Oh wait, that's going to kill the abomination. Oops. We can't play that at the moment. Let's put that into our hand. Bottom of the deck. Okay. Deck. Okay. Just yank something from Mythos. Destroy two here ongoing cards. Oh no, where are my constellations? Okay, so. Yes. What would I like to see come out? Let's put two of those up there so we can destroy them fairly handily. That's because I've got to check whether or not they were clue cards. There, yes it is. Okay. And that appears to have soft locked. Okay, well, it's 10 past 12 for me, so I'm going to go to bed. Thank you all for joining me. That was not good playing by me tonight. I think I may take some time during the week to actually check out the other mods that are there and get to learn to play them better, as well as more of the Cauldron. Right, okay. Right, so thank you to the many, many people who have created these mods. Tomorrow is starting 24 hours ago, 10 minutes ago, will be Handle Up Alive with John and sometimes Jeremy. Thursday's Dolphins Dive with Lou Dolphin for a more strategic look at the various Handle Up games. Saturdays, or Sundays if you're me, Spirit Island Saturdays, where we play Spirit Island on Saturdays. And Sunday will be another letdown with Tales from the Archive, the more story-driven Sentinels experience. And I shall be back here next Monday. Unless I've been given more new mods, I will probably do a bit more of the Sentinels of Stream. And until then, you know, take care. Enjoy yourselves, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.